What's up, everybody? My name is Lenny Kaiser. I'm an Ableton certified trainer, and I'm here to help you finish music. In this video, we're going to learn how to program and sequence drums on the Ableton Move. To help you learn more, I'm providing the Ableton project files created for this video in the link below. So even if you don't have a Move or plan on getting one, you can learn from the project file and use the sounds in your own productions. All right, let's dive in. Let's start a new set by pressing the Shift button and then the Set Overview button. To choose a new project, select a blank pad. Now, I'll select the first track, which by default is a drum rack. To change the drum rack, press the wheel and scroll through the various drum racks. I'm going to use the Oracle Dirty Kit. Okay, let's create the first simple pattern and program our kick. Before we do that though, we need to change the tempo to 135 BPM. To do this, I'll hit the Shift button and the Tempo button. Now I'll use the scroll wheel to change the tempo. Okay, let's program the kick by pressing the kick pad and then pressing a step button. By default, the step grid is set to 16th note divisions. The lines under steps 1, 5, 9, and 13 indicate the start of each beat. I'll enter the kick notes on step 1 and step 8. I want the kick to be higher in pitch. This is to make more room for the bass line later, and I personally just like the sound of kicks that are a little bit higher in pitch. Okay, let's program the snare pad by putting them on beats 2 and 4, which are step buttons 5 and 9. Just look for the lines under the step button. The snare sound is crazy loud, so I'll turn it down by pressing and holding the pad and using the main volume encoder to turn it down. Let's pitch this sample up 3 semitones and also use the built-in low pass filter to take out some of the high frequencies. For the final part of this first simple pattern, let's add a hi-hat on the offbeat. To program the hi-hat on the offbeat, I want to put it on steps 3, 7, 11, and 15. Okay, let's program the second pattern. This is going to be the mid-level energy drums. To start, we need to duplicate the existing low-level drum pattern. First, I'll hit the session mode toggle button, and now I see my clip here. To duplicate the clip, I press the copy button here, then press the pad, then select the blank pad I want to place it on. Let's go back to programming by hitting the track button. Let's program in some shakers with pad 16. I'll place the shakers on steps 2, 12, and 16. For more energy, let's add a layered open hi-hat on top of the other closed hi-hat. I'll put those on steps 3, 7, 11, and 15. And let's add a second snare on steps 8 and 10 to create some ghost notes. Let's also turn the snare down by pressing and holding the pad down and using the main volume encoder to turn it down. I'll also low pass filter it with the first encoder. Now let's add some swing to the beat. To do this, I press the Shift key and step 7, which is the groove symbol here. Now we're done with our mid-level drum pattern. Let's create the high-energy drum pattern next. To do this, I'll duplicate the clip again by going into the session mode. Then I'll press the copy button and the pad, and then place it into a new clip slot. For the high-energy drums, I'm going to add one last sound by using the note repeat function. To access this, I press the Shift button and select Step 11, which has the note repeat icon. I'll also transpose it down one semitone and filter it too. Now to record this in, I'll hit the record button and hold the pad down to record the notes into the clip. To add a little more energy and variation, let's add two extra kicks on steps 11 and 14. I hope you found this video helpful. To further your knowledge and speed up your productions, I'm offering the Ableton Project and the Move Set available for free download from the link below. If you like what you saw and want to learn more about music production and how to finish high quality music, please consider giving this video a like and subscribing to the channel. If you're interested in diving deeper into the Move and Ableton, I have an entire course that walks through every aspect in detail on my website below. Thanks for watching and see you next time.